Anyone see?
Yeah, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Chapter 1 of Beehive, The Fun They Had, written by Isaac Asimov. Have you ever heard about this, heard this name, heard about this writer, Isaac Asimov?
No, ma'am.
You haven't? Okay. How many of you interested in reading science fictions, sci-fi, novels,
me.
Movies?
Me.
Many
me.
Of you
like,
right?
Me.
Yes. Yeah. Okay. And he, we can say that he was considered to be as a giant of science fiction, okay, during his time. So you can understand that this is a short story written by a science fiction writer, and so definitely you can see a few features of science fiction here, sci-fi here. Okay, and he lived in born 1920 and 1992. That was his period. That was his time. And a few of us, I hope you would have heard about iRobot series, iRobot movies. Have you? iRobot, have you seen?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so that,
no, ma'am.
It is all inspired by his short stories. Okay, now we'll see about the author later. Before that, anyhow, coming to the chapter, as I've told you, this is science fiction and written by Isaac Asimov. And now, what will you learn from this lesson is you will know something about what a science fiction is. What are the features of science fiction that you will come to know? More than that, okay, the only thing is this is a science fiction. But we are not going to see more about that. But what are we going to see more about is about educational system. Okay, you will know more about educational system, the present day educational system. What can be the futuristic system of education, right? So by reading that, you will understand what you prefer, what would be your ideal education system, okay? As you are provided with a chance of, so you have experienced the past and you know the future. So now you will be able to compare and choose which one would be ideal. So comparing all the aspects involved in it. Okay. So this lesson will provide you a perspective on what would be an ideal education system in future. And it will give you more insight about school in future, schools of future, futuristic education, futuristic schools. You would have heard about this term, right? And then you would get to know more about the terms, the technological terms, which are involved in the futuristic education, like virtual classroom. You all would be knowing about VR, right? Virtual classroom, virtual reality, AR, augmented reality, technology-aided learning, robotic teachers, e-learning, e-books, synchronous learning, asynchronous learning, so blended learning. There are so many, right? You will all come to know about these terms also. So these are the learning objectives. Let this be here and let us go to the introduction part. Now, children, the last class, when we are discussing about the road not taken point, do you remember I asked you a question? Asking you to make a preference between the regular schooling and the homeschooling, as we're exposed to the homeschooling now. Okay, you're sitting at home and you're learning, right? So now, the last class itself, I asked you what would be your preference if you're given with these two chances when I was taking the class road not taken. Do you remember?
Ma'am, I want to say one thing.
Yes.
Ma'am, last class I was not there.
Okay, fine. Okay, and I think the recorded links are uploaded, Abhiraj. You can see that. Okay?
Yes, ma'am, I saw.
Three chapters. Take some time to watch that also. Okay? So now,
yes, ma'am.
So in the last class, I asked you to decide if I'm giving you two options. One is that you have to continue in this type of online learning. Another one is that is a homeschooling, we can call it as. And another thing is you can go to the regular, go back to the regular schooling. Regular schooling between the online learning, homeschooling. And many of you have suggested or preferred regular schooling, telling that there you have friends, there you have PE classes. Do you remember the last day? These are the answers I got, right? So most of your preferences were, children, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Most
yes,
of your preferences were the regular schooling. So you have considered the aspects that fun, friends, the games, PE classes, playing together, right? Like traveling together. Now keeping that aspect the other side. Don't think about those features, okay? So mainly what a school is for? For the purpose of instructions, instructional purpose, right? Right, instruction means that is providing education, that is education. So if you take only the purpose of instruction, now I am giving you the same question, I'm asking you the same question again. Now let us see the merits, the good aspects and the demerits of it. Okay, so the first I want you to discuss, a few of you to discuss, what do you find the good things in school? I'm just asking only about the instructional methods, okay, not the other aspects. If you take the instruction, the way how the teaching happens in the school, if you think about it now, because the chapter is more about education, so it is very important that we have to discuss about the present education, because this chapter is dealing with the futuristic education. So it's important that we should know the pros and cons of educational system present in the present day, right? And even the past day also, if you want, you can discuss. But now my question is, I'm leaving you with the question. So tell me the good aspects that you find in your regular schooling.
Ma'am, I think I have one.
Yeah, tell me.
So in this online schooling, what happens is that if you have a bad internet connection, sometimes the thing doesn't work.
Sahil, my question is about a few good features of our regular schooling. Good features
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So online, these kinds of problems.
Let me interrupt again. What I'm asking you is without comparing. Okay.
Yeah. So in a regular class, we can talk here to ask doubts.
Yeah. What else? Is there anybody else?
Ma'am, we can interact better with the teachers.
You can interact with
we
the
can
teachers.
We can interact better with the teachers.
Okay. Don't use the word better, because I said not to compare. We can interact with the teacher. You can limit your sentence in that way. We can interact with the teacher.
Teamwork, ma'am.
Very good. Teamwork. We can do teamwork. You are learning with your friends. Then, anybody else? Any other answers? So good. Nitya, do you have any answers? I think we have done so much research about this topic. You would be familiar with the topic.
So basically at school, you can interact with friends better.
You can interact with your friends. It's a teamwork. Okay. And then what else?
And then you develop a bonding with your team.
So now you said that it is easy to interact with your teacher. It's easy to interact with your friends, so that group learning or teamwork is being improved. Okay, that skill of teamwork will get improved. Fine. So now let me ask another question. So what do you find? What are the good aspects of online learning? I mean, this kind of now due to this corona or COVID-19, you are exposed to a new online scenario, right? We all heard about it, but we are not experienced it. So now you are exposed to this online learning scenario, okay? So now, what are the good things you find in it? Now, we have already discussed about the good things, what you found in our regular schooling. And now, what are the good things you find in this type of online learning? If any, you can mention.
So I think that sitting at, like, in a home environment, it's easier to learn because you're more relaxed.
Good. Next. Good point. Anyone else?
This is something new. And if any other thing like this comes, we can get used to it. Like, we are getting used to it, so we will have no problem.
Okay, so now you are learning at your own...
Also, we have shorter school hours.
Okay.
Also, if we have any doubts, we can like clear it right now. But in class, like if we have tests or something, like there's immediate clear. You can like get the.
The strain of travel is not there.
Okay, good. Sujan, right? Sujan's point. Next, is there anything else? So now we have discussed about the good aspects of the good features of both the regular schooling and the online schooling. But is there anybody, those who feel that, no, it is not doing any good for me. This online teaching is not doing any good for me. Is there anybody who has that as no as an answer?
Nobody.
Online schooling, that online teaching is no way comparable with regular teaching. Is there any such answers here?
It's the same thing with we get in the school. The teacher,
no, I think, right?
But there is like one disadvantage in online learning.
Hmm.
Like for subjects like maths or science, the teacher can't actually show us on the board how to do it. Because in online learning, she can't actually, depict what she wants to tell you. That's the communication
there's a whiteboard
problem.
Option also
yeah but you can't write with the mouse
but in the conversation
you can
very good. Okay, that's a very good point. There are certain limitations concerning to certain subjects. Okay, not all the subject teachers are facing this. Maybe a few subjects where using the blackboard, okay, it's of high demand. So such teachers are facing this issue. That's true, right? So now, keeping this thing in mind, just you have discussed about the demerit, the disadvantages. So now let me ask you another question. So you have told a few good points about this online learning also, right? You told that you can learn at your own pace. There is no strain of traveling. You can clear your doubts then and there. Right? So many good things you spoke about and a few demerits also you mentioned. So now, what if or how it would be if more advanced, if we made it more advanced by adapting more advanced technology into it, right? So now, just eradicating the demerits, whatever you have mentioned. As you said, there are more good features here in online learning or online teaching according to your point, right? But there are a few demerits. We can eliminate those demerits by adapting more advanced technologies. When I say about advanced technologies, on the screen you can see a few terms, right? So for example, if I say, you can see the virtual classroom. So for example, when I say we can make it more effective by adapting technology, advanced technology. For example, the last class when I was teaching you the Rona Tekan, I was trying to make you feel what the author had got when he was there standing alone in the forest. There was two roads in front of him. He wanted to continue his journey. He wanted to choose anyone, right? So I was trying to explain that setting to you. For explaining the setting, what I had done was, I have shown you a picture, right? A picture on the PPT, right? That is what I have done. How it would have been if I had shown you or if I had taken you a virtual tour to a forest? Are you able to understand?
Yes.
If you have been taken for a virtual tour in the forest, so you are standing in the forest, in the middle of the forest, in front of two roads, so you can feel that dilemma, you can feel that, you can get that feel. So all these things can be added to the online learning scenario with advanced technologies, right? VR, augmented reality, virtual reality, all these advanced technologies will aid to give you more realistic feeling, right? So this will, if you are adapting to such technological advancement in our online teaching, what are the demerits you have discussed now will not be taken place. Okay, that is what we are going to see. So now I told you about VR, implementing, or we are adapting a few more advanced technologies. So when I told you about, I am providing with a virtual classroom environment. Okay, and I am providing you the freedom of learning at your own pace. Now, see, can you see the terms at the last line? Synchronous learning, asynchronous learning. Do you know about synchronous learning and asynchronous learning? So what do you mean by synchronous learning is, now what we are doing, that we can call it as synchronous learning. Okay, so there is, teaching is happening online, and you, all the students are there, right? And you are learning at the same time, and the learning pace is the same. That is what synchronous learning. Okay, there might be some student feeling it difficult to wake up a morning and to sit in front of the system at this time. The other one would be very comfortable with the system. But unmindful of that, you're all asked to sit, and you're all asked to log into the same time and to listen to the class. Okay, so this type of learning is synchronous learning. Online teaching is happening at the same time for a group of students, what we call it as a synchronous learning. What do you mean by asynchronous learning is, and now you feel that, no, my learning pace is different. I can't learn as fast as the other one, right? I want a different time, a different environment. If you feel that, okay, the online teaching to be done in that way, if you feel in that way, so how it can be, that is, so you are having the online teaching and you're logging in your own time, your own pace, you're learning at your own pace. So there is a teacher, okay, teacher teaching you according to your own comfortability, your own comfort time, your own comfort, the speed of learning, all these things will be considered. So the online teaching, when it is happening to one student in one particular time, that is what asynchronous learning, that you are not studying it in group. Okay, so now if you see what we used to have in our classroom, that what we call us is instructional led learning. That is it. So an instructor is there in one place, you're all going to that place and you're learning, and so you're learning in a group, right? So there is no medium in between. So you are in a place, there is no digital media in between, fine? So when a digital media comes in between, that is called synchronous learning. We are in the place of synchronous learning, but what the futuristic education is mainly focusing on is synchronous learning. That is, each learner is different. So differentiated learning. A learner should happen, instructions should happen according to one's own time, according to one's student's own pace. Okay, it should not be the similar for everybody. That is what. So now, as I told you, okay, so if we are implementing few more technological advancements, adapting few more technological advancements in our classrooms, in our teaching, in our instructional methodology, how it should be? So first I told you, you have been introduced to a virtual classroom, a virtual reality, and you are learning in your own learning pace. Okay, and another thing is, now when you are being taught, okay, now you don't have to sit in front of your boring teachers, the stereotype teaching, okay, and you can be taught by something different, that is by robots, machine.
Robots.
Robotic teachers. Are you not interested in that something? See, I heard that there is a restaurant in Indranagar. Have you ever been there? A robot restaurant. Children? So there is a restaurant in Indranagar. It is a robot restaurant. So where the orders will be taken by the robots and the delivery will be done by the robots. And see, what is the main feature it is attracting the students is robot. Okay, that's small children. The kids is robots. So it is very curious to see the robot serving you, coming to you, right, taking the orders. So in the same way, so how it should be if your stereotype teachers are replaced with robots? That is what the dream of the futuristic educational, the educators, those who are planning for futuristic education. Do you understand that now? So now we are going to speak about the time, how when we are transported to, where we are transported to. Okay, a place where you are in a virtual classroom, you are learning in your own pace, you don't have to compete with your friends, okay, and you are being taught by a robot, a mechanical teacher. That is what the setting, that is what the scenario provided in front of you by the author. Okay, Isaac Asimov. Now, let me open the textbook. Wait. No, let us see a few more about the author. So is the introduction clear to you children? What is the story about? Is it clear to you? Children, you can mute.
Yes, ma'am.
As I told you, we are going to see a future, how it would be in future. After we can say that in 23rd or 24th century, after 200 years ahead. So we are going to see that as a setting. Okay, and as you know, in most of the science fictions, how a science fiction would be, it would be dealing with somewhere years ahead, centuries ahead, in different planets, in different universe. That is how it would be, right? So now we are going to see a lesson where it is happening in 2157. So if you calculate the time, almost 137 year ahead from now, right? Almost 1.5 century. By that time, when the story occurs, when it happened in real, you all would become ancestors, right? So now that is the setting which is provided in front of us. And we are getting two characters. There are two characters, two students like you who are discussing about their own schooling. So their own schooling in the sense, as I told you, the futuristic school. So the author is dreaming that as if the futuristic education has come to implementation, it has implemented, and the students, those who are experiencing, attending such type of schooling, what is their mindset? And when they come to know about the past, okay, the past, the regular school, like the school, how, like what we are having. When they come to know about the past, what was their reaction about it? What was their, how do they feel about it? So, okay, that is what we are going to see. So if you see the title, The Fun They Had, okay, you may interpret the title. I don't know in what way you're taking that. So now you may think that we are talking about the fun. The students, those who are in that time, in 23rd century, and what fun it would have been for them for having sitting in the virtual classroom, enjoying the classes taught by a mechanical teacher, a robotic teacher, and you are learning at your own pace. You don't have to travel. So you may think that that is fun, but let us see what they are thinking. Okay, when they come to know about the real schooling, what they are thinking. That's what the story is giving you as about, no, discussing about. Now, so as I told you, you will learn about science fiction. That was what we are going to discuss now. And now you will come to know what is your ideal education system. So you, like I've given you some idea about, okay, your regular schooling, how your futuristic schooling would be, what would be the features of the futuristic schooling, all these things. And now you can take a decision. Okay, the preference is yours. What is an ideal education system for you? Analyzing the pros and cons, and you will know about the future school. So this is the learning objective. And now about the author. He is Isaac Asimov. He's an American writer, as well as he's a professor in Boston University. He's a professor of biochemistry. Okay, and he was known as the giant of science fiction during his lifetime. And his famous science fictions are Foundation series, Galactic Empire series, and iRobot series. I am sure at least you would have heard about this iRobot. Okay, so these were his famous collection, the series of books. And he has won so many awards also, including lifetime awards, honorary awards, doctorate degrees and all. Here in this lesson, he is talking about how the school would be in future, that is in 2157. And now if you see, this year is his century of year, that is the 100th anniversary of his birthday. Was born on January 2nd. Oh, sorry, the month is not there. 2nd of January. So recently his 100th anniversary of his birth was celebrated. Okay, that is what the information about him. Now, See, now let us see more about what is a science fiction. What generally are the features of science fiction? And you know very well that science fiction is generally talking about something transporting you to a future, right? A future time. And another thing is transporting you to another place. The setting is not your place, right? Setting is not your, what, like where you're living. It is, it may, the setting may be in a space, in a different world, in a different universe, or in a different dimension. Okay, that is the salient feature of science fiction. And so now here are a few famous authors and their books of science fiction. Have you heard about H.G. Wells, was the father of science fiction? Was written War of the Worlds and Invisible Man. You have a lesson in your grade 10. When you come to grade 10, you have a lesson written by H.G. Wells, that is Invisible Man, and Jules Verne. Okay, so here, they are the science fiction, the authors of science fiction, pioneers, okay, of that time. And now if you see the present time, we have George Orwell and Aldous Huxley, Arthur C. Clarke, and we have so many. Isaac Asimov, also he belongs to the present century, 20th century, right? So now, you learned something about what a science fiction is. And do you agree this lesson also is a science fiction?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
ma'am. Why?
Because it has robots and online virtual.
Because it tells us about the future learning.
Very good. It's talking about the future. It's happening in future. Okay. Two centuries ahead. It's talking about future learning. So, keeping the principles of science. Okay. So, now if you see another feature of science fiction, we can say that cannot be, like that's partially true. But majorly, the partially, the remaining part is maybe very fictitious. Okay. So, based on the scientific principles, partially true. But more fictitious characters and more fictitious incidents, you can see that. That is what one of the features of the science fiction is. And here also, what we are having here is a science fiction. This is a science fiction. And now coming to next. So now, I'm giving you, see, as you see the previous slide, the question is, you will come to know about what is an ideal education system for you. I'm leaving this question to you. You can decide, okay, which can be an ideal one. And now see this. This is what you're seeing on the first picture is the earlier Gurukul education system, where it is, we can majorly say about, see, the teacher is sitting and teaching, the students are listening to them, right? So the learning, it is one way teaching is happening. What we call it is teacher-centric instruction. Okay, it is teacher-centric. The teacher is delivering the lesson and the students are supposed to sit and listen. Of course, they can clarify their doubts later, but it is what the teacher's idea is transported to. Okay, it's transferred to the student. That is what the teacher-centric education is. Now, if you see the second picture, that is what we can see almost in our like, present-day education system, right? Yeah, so this is what? The teacher is allowing you to explore. So the learning is happening, okay, by giving you a, like, we can now call the teacher. We no more call the teachers now. We call them as facilitators. So you are being like facilitated by the person. You are being provided with an education, with an environment where you can learn better. You can explore. You can learn on yourself. You can come out with your own findings. So that is what you are seeing in the second picture. That is what majorly, which is what's happening in our present day education scenario. Yes. So here what is happening, what is contrary to the previous picture is where it was teacher-centric education, here it is learner-centric education. Okay, so what do you expect the students would do? They are doing some activity, they will come out with some finding, and what the teacher is doing, he's just facilitating. Okay, he's not doing anything else, he's just facilitating, right, helping the students. That is what is happening now. And what should be in future? A robot, a real robot, teaching, solving, mathematics, everything. Okay, so now this is the past, present, and future of education. Here, actually, in this lesson, Isaac Asimov, when he had written this, when he wrote this lesson, the short story, it was in 1951, right? And he predicted that in the 23rd and 24th century, the instruction, like, you know, the education or that, like, the teaching field would solely by taken by taken up by robots. But do you agree that it has happened much earlier, even now itself? Have you heard about this? Look at this slide. Have you seen or have you heard about this anywhere?
It's in the school in Bangalore.
Yeah, she knows because we have done this research during our debate time. So she is a robotic teacher, right? It's real. In Bangalore, in one of the international schools in Bangalore, they started trying with a robotic teacher in last year itself, in 2019 itself. Her name is Eagle, and she teaches physics here with the help of the facilitator, the teacher. Okay, so now this is what the scenario would be in future schooling. You would be taught by a robotic teacher, by a machine. Okay, but here, what would be the difference in future? What Asimov is predicting is the way. Here you can see a classroom setting where all the students are sitting together and the instruction is happening. It is being done by, delivered by a robotic teacher. But what Asimov is predicting is you will not be grouped in the same place. You will not be in a same place, sitting in the same place. Okay, you will be in different places. You'll be sitting alone, okay, in your own home, virtual classroom. That is what the scenario would be. That is what he is predicting. Fine. So now going to the overview of the chapter that we'll see. But before that, let me take the PDF. Now I'm just stopping this slide. So I think I have provided you with some introduction about the chapter. Okay. Now let me open the PDF. Can you all see the lesson?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Now I'll check the page. So
no, ma'am. We can only see.
Yeah, it's a screen.
Can you see the PDF?
No, ma'am.
We can't see the PDF.
The PDF hasn't
been. You can't? You can't see the lesson?
No, ma'am.
It's like it's loading.
It's loading.
Yeah.
Now?
Yeah.
Yes,
yeah. Right. So now, see, this is what the virtual classroom setting. This is what we are seeing in this lesson. Okay, the main characters of the lesson. This is what the type of the school they are attending. Okay, schools in future. So how the schools in future would be? Have virtual classroom, learning through computer, of course, and you will have e-text. So that is another major feature. Okay, here in this school, what they're talking is a paper has become a relic for them. They have not seen a book, a textbook, because they are reading everything online, right? So you will have a virtual classroom, learning through computer, a robotic teacher, moving e-text. These are all the virtual classroom setting you are going to see in this lesson. Okay, so this is what the virtual classroom setting is, and I think we can start the lesson, reading the lesson tomorrow. But I think I have covered a major part of it, what the lesson is about, right? I told you this is a science fiction. I told you what it is about in science fiction, what the main theme is. It's about education, that is the futuristic education. And now you have got some idea about what would be the future features of the futuristic education, the technological, the advanced technologies of future education system, right? The virtual reality, augmented reality, blended learning, synchronous and asynchronous learning. So these are the thing that you are going to know. And you here, I told you there are two students. They are in the virtual learning atmosphere, and that they are in 23rd and 24th century. They came to know about how the regular schooling was in 20th century and before that also, and what was their response to it. That is what we are going to see in the lesson. Let us see the lesson in the next class as the time is up. Okay, and before that, you have a homework as well. I'll show you, I'll share the homework. The homework is nothing that I told you. There are a few terms that you have to learn before you know anything about the futuristic education. Okay, so that is what you have to do is, you have to do some research about futuristic learning, and you have to come out with this, the explanation of this terms. Okay, so this is today's assignment. You are writing about technology. So do a research, children, because you should, it's very important that we should know about how learning would be in the future scenario. So technology-aided learning, what do you mean by technology-aided learning? The definition, or what is robotic teacher? What are robotic teachers? Virtual classroom, e-books, synchronous learning, asynchronous learning. Okay, I want you to write a short note on all these. Short note in the sense it is not only the definition that you are copying from Wikipedia or somewhere or Google. Okay, and so now by understanding that, you are writing what is technology.